Hello, welcome to the topic Educational Philosophy. Scope of Philosophy in Education. Philosophy is one of the oldest disciplines and considered as the mother of all sciences. It is a search for understanding the meaning of life and its relation with the universe. Philosophy provides a guidance to lead a better life through the quest for truth and knowledge. Quest for truth is the truth about life and its meaning. An improvement of the present life is possible through acquiring knowledge, which in turn may lead to wisdom. Philosophy is a comprehensive system of thoughts about the nature of human beings and the nature of reality they live in. Education provides methodologies to learn certain knowledge and skills in a proper way. In other words, education helps an individual in a well thought out and systematic way in his or her search for truth, value, and skills. The goal of education, as that of in philosophy, is to help a person in attaining an opportunity to improve his or her life. One can improve one's life through various ways. For instance, by improving one's action, character, and ways of seeing the world is a mode that makes one's life more meaningful. Another method of improving one's life is through attaining material benefits in terms of wealth and upward mobility or progress. If philosophy provides the intellectual tools for improving actions and character, education provides the skills and training for improving one's life through material, ethical, and cultural benefits. In short, both education and philosophy provide certain skills that are essential to live in the world and to relate with other human and non-human beings in the universe. Thus, philosophy and education are interlinked within their goal in improving human life. The scope of philosophy in education cannot be separated from the philosophy of education. The basic principle on which education is built upon is known as philosophy of education. Education draws its basic tenets from different philosophical traditions. Education disciplines a person physically and mentally. Philosophy disciplines a person intellectually and spiritually. For Western philosophy, this spiritual part is less important and the intellectual part gains more currency. In Eastern philosophical tradition, the intellectual part is not separated from spiritual. In other words, Western philosophy is an intellectual quest for truth, whereas the Eastern philosophy emphasizes the practical realization of truth. Theory and practice are not separate in Eastern philosophical traditions, or else a practice need not be always explained through a theory. Both the traditions are scientific and rational in their own terms. Generally, the Western philosophical tradition is known as scientific, and the Eastern philosophic traditions are named as religious. If education helps one to assess and validate one's own values and beliefs, then philosophy enhances a person's quest for truth. Philosophy of education is a method or approach to maintain this quest for truth. Through this method, an individual can set certain norms to measure up on their own life. This could be through economic benefit in terms of upward mobility with a better job opportunity. This could also be through a refinement of one's own thought or action, that is, through the improvement of values and ethics in life. Education provides a set of techniques for imparting knowledge and skill. Philosophy is a foundation to vitalize these goals of education. Philosophy defines what's worth living, and education prepares one for that. Education consists of a number of processes such as teaching, instructing, advising, motivating, and correcting people. Through these methods, it enhances an individual's inherent abilities and refines their existing abilities. The methods in education are derived from the principles of various philosophical traditions. The philosophy of education intends to help an individual to make use of his or her creative potentials. It also helps an individual to become more social in their interaction and exchange with other human beings. To put it short, education supports an individual to become a more responsible citizen. It provides the basic tools that enables an individual to interact with various government institutions. Education is a must for any person to deal with various departments of the government. An illiterate person is seen as one who does not have sufficient skill and knowledge to understand the procedures of the institutions of the government. Literacy is a minimum essential requirement to understand the governmental processes. An education is a ground that provides literacy. It increases the cognitive and perceptive capacity by providing reading, writing, and thinking skills. This does not mean that an individual is in any case not capable of thinking. He or she has the innate capacity of thinking and acting, which will be refined through education by adding additional skills of reading and writing. The new skills enable an individual to enter into a world which has more possibilities. Relation between education and philosophy. The word education is derived from the Latin word educare, which means to bring forth what is within an individual. It also means to give something like skills and knowledge which is not already there within an individual. Almost all the philosophers from Aristotle onwards approach education as a powerful tool to impart the skills required for a better life in refining an individual. Education is one of the systems through which the accumulated knowledge in a society is transmitted or disseminated to the next generation. There are a number of other systems also through which knowledge and skills are transmitted from generation to generation. Some of them are informal or non-formal education, apprenticeship, and traditional ways of disseminating knowledge from generation to generation. There are different views on education as well as different understanding about the meaning of education. For instance, the well-known educational philosopher John Dewey had seen education as something that keeps the social continuity of life. Here, education provides skills and knowledge that enhance the individual's capacity of pursuing their own goals without harming the fellow beings. It also allows an individual's ability to participate in a social life and become autonomous and efficient citizen. The important shift in this view of education is that people have been seen as individuals. The individuals have to observe and maintain certain rights and duties as citizens in their relation with the state. The ancient education did not intend to create individual citizens, even though the basic aim of education in that period too was for the betterment of the life of a person. Some of the philosophers disagree in giving importance for formal education or school, college, university-based education as a tool that provides skill and knowledge. They argue that formal education disciplines an individual in a particular way and destroys his or her innate ability of acquiring knowledge and skill from the life situations in which he or she lives. They have also seen formal education as something that destroys the coping up strategy and cognitive capacity inherent in human beings. Paulo Freire strongly argues for informal educational opportunities. Informal education has taken place in each and every life situations, whereas non-formal education has taken place through institutions, but it is highly learner-centered. Informal education is a lifelong process and has no strict formalities or rules. A person can attain knowledge and skill that improves his or her life from the complexity of any life situations. The basic aim in this process is not education, but participating and involving in different life situations in productive ways. Here, education is a byproduct of interacting with diverse spaces, works, and life situations. There is no strict syllabus for informal education, but there can be rules or regulations within particular skill training or occupation in which an individual is involved. Non-formal education has a time frame, goal, and it observes some formalities and rules that are conducive to the learners. In non-formal education, as in formal institutions, rules and pre-designed syllabus determine the content of education. It is meant for people of all kinds without any age limit, but with pre-planned rules, methods, and timings. Formal education is imparted through institutions designed by the government or through the approved agencies of government. Informal education has no such pre-designed methods or strict rules. All types of education, such as formal education, informal education, and non-formal education, are based on their own philosophies. The fundamental philosophical urge in all types of education is to improve an individual's action, thought, and life. In formal education and non-formal education, these goals are attained through training based on pre-designed methods, syllabus, and strict rules. The training in these two forms of education has happened in selected institutional spaces such as schools or training centers. In informal educational situations, there are no such specific and well-defined spaces for training. The philosophy of informal education is based on the fundamental principles of learning from each and every life situations. This learning happens through tackling issues and dangers encounter in each occasions, and also through interaction and dealings with other human beings. Actually, this mode also provides an in-depth training in life, but usually we are not aware of the training because of its informal nature. Since it's part of life and happens in each moment, one cannot treat it as an informal education or learning process. Functions of philosophy of education. Philosophy of education is the application of philosophy in all spheres of education. The goals, concepts, processes, institutions, and theories of education are determined by a series of philosophical perspectives. No matter formal, informal, or non-formal, the purpose of education is not merely transmission of knowledge and skills. It equally fosters reasoning skills and inquiry, which are important in the development of an autonomous individual. In education, philosophy works as applied philosophy. It enhances the capacity of an individual to question the issues within philosophy. Educational philosophy addresses a few issues inherent within the process of education. They can be summarized as follows: purpose of education, value of education, relationship of education with other political, economical, and cultural field, interpretation of human nature in relation with the universe, interpretation of theory of knowledge or epistemology. Philosophy critically evaluates the purpose and aim of education. Some of the main purposes of education can be summarized as follows: harmonious human development, personal development, making responsible citizen, maintaining time management, technological development, providing skills and tools meant for progress. Philosophy helps to make a harmonious relation between the old and new traditional values of education, depending on the scientific and rational nature of them. Philosophy of education guides the planners and administrators of education to make suitable policies, syllabus, and teaching methods. It also helps the educators in attaining the goals of education. Generally, philosophy has expressed in three different modes: normative, speculative, and critical. These modes reflect in the philosophy of education too. Normative philosophy deals with the formation of norms, rules, customs, standards, and guidelines that are necessary for different life situations. The important concerns of philosophy here are the moral, ethical, and aesthetical values. Education is a process of transmission of various things such as skills, knowledge, values, attitudes, behavior patterns, etc. These values are considered as worthwhile for individuals. Normative educational philosophy inquires into the ethical and moral dimensions of education. Speculative philosophy produces ideas and perspectives through inquiries around general human experience. The ideas and perspectives in speculative philosophy is developed not merely through a personal experience. It also considers community's experience and the existed past customary practices. Critical philosophy is also known as analytical philosophy. Critical or analytical philosophers elucidate concepts and validate them through general principles. It also critiques many existing concepts, arguments, and theories. Philosophy of education dealt with important issues and concerns within education. It offers arguments and norms, clarifies concepts and ideas. It provides a frame of reference and a direction not only in the field of education but also in life situations. It sets standards for human beings in their aims and values and validates them through notions of ethics, aesthetics, progress, or development. Philosophy of education also enlightens the students about various important concepts such as equality, democracy, freedom, etc. It clarifies concepts, analyzes arguments and theories, and substantiates them with facts and evidences. The objects of philosophical inquiry in education includes the process of learning and teaching, curriculum, guidelines on aims of education, methods, tools used, and system of schooling. Most educational philosophers work in contributing to educational content, policies, and practices. Impact of Western and Indian philosophy in education. Even though diverse perspectives exist in both Western and Indian philosophical traditions, all of these perspectives did not reflect in the philosophy of education. The most prevalent Indian philosophical tradition that influenced education is the humanistic, pragmatic, and realistic traditions. And the dominant Western philosophical traditions that influenced education are idealism, realism, rationalism, and liberalism. Humanism. Humanistic education envisages the complete development of a human being. It emphasizes all democratic values like equality, fraternity, and freedom of each person. In this tradition, education upholds human values by integrating psychological and sociological elements of a child. Humanism considers a holistic view of the cosmic world in which a harmonious relation is possible between human and non-human world. Pragmatism. The Indian or rather Asian philosophy upholds the school of pragmatism in its tradition. In this school, a person's existence is relational. It is determined by his or her relation with other beings in the universe. Hence, uncertainties are more compared to certainties of life. Instead of making big goals and act upon to attain that goal, a person needs to be trained to adjust with a situation and adapt according to the potential and possibilities of the situation. Realism. Realism is in opposition with idealism. In this mode, philosophers give emphasis to the reality of life and the material world within which one lives. The objective knowledge and the quality of it exist outside the mind of a person. In realism, the mind or thought interact with the material world out there and then only decided to intervene and change the world. Here, knowledge is a posteriori or dependent on experience. Idealism. Idealism is an old and prominent philosophical tradition. It upholds ideal logic about the harmony of human being and nature. The existence of human life in the world is treated with utmost importance. Human beings are seen as people with supreme power who can intervene in the world and change it according to their dream or desire. In idealistic philosophy of education, ideas and ideals are the pinnacle of education. These ideas are sprouted within the invisible realm of mind when it interacts with the world outside. It is known as idealism because it does not count the reality and the obstacles in the real world while planning to intervene and change the world. It also does not consider the uncertainties of life. Rationalism. Rationalism believes in reason to validate the truth in any knowledge. Here, knowledge is a priori or independent of experience. In this tradition, knower or the knowing subject has a central role rather than the knowledge. The knower or the knowing subject acquires certain knowledge by using her or his intellectual and rational thoughts or mind. Here, knowledge is self-evident, universal, and contains necessary truths. But a knowing person needs to be sane and rational to gather knowledge and validate truth. Liberalism. Liberalism upholds the freedom and importance of an individual. The humanistic concepts of liberty, equality, fraternity, freedom, and democracy are closely related with the ideology of liberalism. In liberal education, an individual is trained to use their reason or rational thinking for taking independent decisions. Liberal education teaches an individual the arts of listening, speaking, writing, thinking, and observation. Literally, liberal education is that one liberates a person from ignorance and oppression. Literacy is the prime component in liberal education. In contemporary Indian education, one can see an amalgamation of pragmatism, idealism, realism, humanism, rationalism, and liberalism. Each of the components varies according to the priority of the content of education. There is also critical and analytical tradition in education. The analytical philosophers help to eliminate the language and discourse of education. Let me summarize the main points in this session. In this unit, we have looked at the scope of philosophy in education and the relation between philosophy and education. Different functions of philosophy of education are analyzed, and the impact of Western and Indian philosophies in education is also described. The basic principle of education is derived from various philosophical traditions. Philosophy is the quest for truth, whereas education provides the tools and methodologies to initiate that quest. Irrespective of the nature of education, all modes of education, the formal, informal, and non-formal education, are based upon certain philosophies. Indian education is mainly influenced by idealism, realism, pragmatism, humanism, rationalism, and liberalism. Now, you may try to answer the questions given here. What are the different functions of philosophy? Summarize the important aspects of the relation between education and philosophy. Philosophy and education are interlinked in their goals. Substantiate this argument. What are the differences between idealism and pragmatism? How does rationalism differ from realism? Which are the important philosophical schools that influence Indian education? Now, you can go through the books and websites for your further reading and understanding. Educational Thought and Practice by Taneja Vyas, 2000, New Delhi, Sterling. Philosophy of Education, Chandra S.S. and Rajendra K. Sharma, 2002, New Delhi, Atlantic Publishers. Stanford Encyclopedia of Philosophy, www.plato.stanford.edu. Thank you for watching this program. Hope that you have enjoyed this session. We can meet again with another topic. Take care.